Now, I don't know about you, but I just don't go all around town revealing stuff to anybody that I just don't know. What's going on, Power Director peeps? It's Saturday, and today I'm going to show you how to do the text reveal effect using PowerDirector 18 and PowerDirector 365. If you're new to my channel and you want to learn how to use PowerDirector, click on the subscribe button and then click on the bell so you get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. If you've been looking for a way to do a cool text reveal, I want you to put hashtag text reveal in the comment section below. Here we are in PowerDirector. The text reveal effect makes it look like text is appearing from an object that's moving across the screen. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to make the text reveal effect for your videos. Let's start revealing some things. As you can see, I have a clip of a baby walking across the screen. If I go ahead and click on play, you go ahead, baby. You see that little baby? Okay, that's good. So I want to make some text appear as the baby gets his walk on. So I want to create a text sandwich, which means I'm going to have the text in the middle and two of the identical clips above and below it. So in order to do that, I need at least three tracks. So right now I only have two tracks. So I'm going to go down to track two. I'm going to right click on it. I'm going to select add tracks. And right now it's going to add an audio and video track below track two. So I'm good to go. So I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. Next thing I need to do is add my bread to this text sandwich. So I'm going to go ahead and left click on this baby clip, hold down my left mouse and drag it down to track one right at the beginning. Then I'm going to copy it by right clicking on it and selecting copy. Then I'm going to go down to track three. I'm going to left click on that. Make sure that my playhead is at the beginning of this track. I'm going to right click. I'm going to select paste, and then I'm going to select paste and overwrite. So now I got the bread for my text sandwich. Now I need the text, but before I do that, I got to do a few quick things here. The first thing I want to do is move my playhead to a position where the baby is on the screen and where I want the text to start showing up. And that is a great spot right there. So I'm going to left click on the clip in track three, and then I'm going to split it. So now I'm going to make sure that my playhead stays where it's at. I'm going to go to the title room. And you can select whatever beautiful text and font and all that stuff that you want. I'm going to keep it simple right now, and I'm just going to take the default text. I'm going to left click on it, hold down my left mouse, and I'm going to drag this down to track two. So now I basically got my little text sandwich. I want to make sure that this is dragged out to a position where I want the text to stay on the screen. So depending on how long you want the text to stay on the screen, you just do that. I guess I'll just leave it on the screen until like the baby walks off the screen. Now I'm going to double click on the text. And you can make whatever adjustments you want to the text. I'm just going to type the word baby in here. And let's see, let's go ahead and add a shadow. And I think we're good there. Next thing I need to do is just move this text to where I want it to be on the screen once it's finished being revealed. So since it's coming from, the baby's walking from left to right, then I'm going to move the text over here to the left so that it can be revealed. And this is where it'll show up after the baby finishes walking across the screen. So I just use my arrow keys to just move it over to the left. So now I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. So now I need to use the mask designer to mask the bottom clip on top of the text. Because if we play this right now, we're not going to see the text at all. And the reason why is because we have this clip below it. So what I need to do is make this clip below it move over to the left so that the text can start to reveal itself. and the clip of the baby, which is underneath it, is going to stay on the screen, so you're not even going to see the clip move to the left. Basically, all you're going to see is the word baby getting revealed. So let's go ahead and left click on this. Then we'll go up to designer. And then we'll go to mask designer. So for this, I'm going to select the mask of the entire screen. So I'm going to left click on that. And now you can see that it's already basically covering up part of the word baby. So what I want to do is I'm going to move it all the way over to the left. So the whole word baby is covered up. And I'm going to add a position keyframe right here to lock it into this position. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the go to next keyframe button. And I'll see where the baby moves. And then I'll move the mask over so that it starts to reveal the word, but I'm not gonna make sure that you don't cross the baby. Then I'm gonna move another keyframe. And I'm gonna move it over again. Once again, making sure that I don't cover up any part of the baby. And I'm just gonna keep on going one frame at a time and moving over to reveal the baby or the word baby for each frame. And once you're finished with all of your keyframes, just go ahead and click on OK. And then we go ahead and play this back. Look at that baby. And that's how you make the text reveal effect in CyberLink PowerDirector 18 and PowerDirector 365. If you decide that you like PowerDirector and you want to buy or upgrade to the software or purchase a 365 annual subscription, I'll leave some links in the video description. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again soon.